And welcome everybody here to the game between Revival Gaming and Power Rangers. This is round 16, aka the quarterfinal here. Is it the quarterfinal? I think it is. It's either the quarterfinal or the round before that. Doesn't matter too much. It's still just a best of one. Meaning that it's gonna be all or nothing for both of these teams here, as both of them of course want to get into the qualifiers for the Shanghai Major first, and then go of course into the main event and try and get their own piece of the 3 million there. Having that said, this game, we're gonna be focusing on it first with the Lone Druid and Oracle Ban, very popular bans here in the EU scene. Same goes for the Vengeful Spirit and Io. These heroes, you don't see them too often, mostly because they get banned right now. Vengeful has really been, in the beginning, not been banned, and now they start to ban it because they don't really want to deal with it anymore. And thanks, Vivian Legimin, for hosting me. Having that said, let's take a look here. Gyrocopter Invoker combination coming out for Revival. It's actually a pretty fun combination. You can just... Well, first of all, Power Rangers should ban Bane now. Secondary, if you just get a homing missile, you have to go after someone. You just max it and then you throw the Sunstrike on them. And you pretty much get them the guaranteed kill in the early game. If you put the Bane there as well, you just put a homing missile into Nightmare. And then you just wait for the homing missile to connect, you know, take it easy. And then you throw down the Sunstrike and you get also an easy kill. I think Revival watched the stream or the game before and they're taking out the Dead Prophet. Don't really want to give that one away to Cheshire Cat here. It's understandable. It's a little bit of a strong hero for them. But PR says, okay, well, we'll just go back to our Beastmaster here again. We'll still figure out some kind of way to push as Desmond and Dying Bros. The same support combination as before, being played by RM and, of course, J4. J4 is the Undying RM. I think it's pronounced differently. Remake? Reman? I don't know. Oh, that's came after the game. Having that said, Power Rangers pick up Dazzle and Dying, Beastmaster, and Sven here is the fourth pick. So that's gonna be a core Sven, and they picked it up pretty early. It kind of surprised me that they picked it up against such a ranged lineup, as well as having the Tusk there with the shards to keep you out. Revival might be looking at something to keep Sven away in the form of an Earthshaker, just to get this area where he can't get past as well, just have this double block going with that. Or still, I wouldn't say Bane is too bad of a pick here. Beastmaster is really the only one who can stop you if you use your Fiend Script on Sven, and you know, you can have your team go after Beastmaster and then just go from there. Should be pretty easy. So that wouldn't be too bad to do for them. I do like that. So, I mean, that's it for now for Revival Gaming. It's most likely going to be a support pick now. Tusk might just be in the offlane. Not 100% sure if they will do that, but it might be. So, just picking up a support right now would be good. Radiant team back. Oh, Jakiro! Oh, well, I was typing in the Twitch chat. They pick up the Jakiro here. One of my all favorite heroes. At least I was correct and they're gonna pick up a support now. So, wasn't too bad of a call, but Jakiro, I love this hero. Really with plus 7 damage right now, you can do so much with him. Liquid Fire spam on the offlane are so annoying. Though Beastmaster is able to deal with him pretty effectively. Yes, there's a lot of harassment coming out, but still, it kind of goes both ways in that sense. But it's one of those supports that can just solo siege a tower down. Which means that if you give him a lane on zone, there's no one against him. You're going to lose your tower in 1 or 2 minutes, so you will always have to go back there and do something against it. Will. Mm-hmm. Fuck typing. And now Zeus. Ooh, fine. That's fun. So we're gonna have Zeus here for the PR side. So it's gonna be against Evoker. It's gonna be a Sven position one and the Beastmaster and the Offlane with an Undying Dazzle. Delays for PR pretty static though. That's the one thing here. I don't think they can gank too much. For Revival with the Tusk here, they might be able to do a lot more. Zeus is really in here with a 10 to stay in the lane. Maybe if he can get like a great rune, he will go for the gank. But apart from that, eh. Yeah. For Katana Boy, I can pretty much answer the question as well for the Wisp. It's indeed. Because it's an annoying hero. This global presence, as well as just this. This isn't one of those heroes that kind of changed the game. Same goes for the Broodmother here that gets banned as well. And it, you just have to adjust so much of your playstyle to deal with it. Apart from that, you sometimes also see the Night Stalker ban as well. This is kind of for the same reason. So yeah. No, you don't go aggressive tri-lanes against an IO. It doesn't work. Because usually when you pick up an IO in your team, you're going to set really solid lanes. So if you go a dual against a tri-lane, the dual lane is going to break even. And then you have your tri-lane that's going against a dual lane. If you break even, it's just not enough for a tri-lane to do that. And then you're going to lose mid because you have just one versus two there with an IO tiny. Let's say this is not going to work. And then you have a solo matchup somewhere that you're usually going to pick heroes for that also win that. So, that tends to be all in favor of the IO, so don't really go for that. I would really not do that. They can't really pull mid. Also, it's the dire side, right? Revival Gaming? This time around, so that's not gonna work. I'm sorry about that, man. You at least tried it, I guess. So well, anyhow, let's just big stretch here. Let's get all ready. Let's take a fast sip of my milk. Okay, I'm all ready. Gotta keep in mind that PR are playing from an internet cafe, so it's always a little bit harder for them. Gonna change one thing about my settings real fast while we haven't really completely started yet. This one should be a bit lower. I played a game yesterday night. Oop. Normal sister. Okay, we're into the game. Okay, this seems like the normal one. Yeah, this is cool. Ooh, 5 views from Lizard Dota. Woo! We did it, man! We did it! Anyhow, let's just do a quick introduction. This is Power Rangers against Revival Gaming. This is round number 16 in the Shanghai Major European Qualifier. Number 2 with me on the stats is at Burno _. I am at Sen _Dota. In our chat, we have Lizard who will answer all your analytical questions so I don't have to do anything in the stream anymore. And why the hell is it going like this? I think I have a bug. Oh, that's not going to be fun. I go one forward. Okay, it's good. Let's see if it stays like this. I hope so. Otherwise, I might have to reconnect real fast. Anyhow, for the side of PR, we're going to have Cheshire Cat playing the Zeus. Big numbers on the Beastmaster. Recovery is going to be playing Sven. J4 is on the Undying. And RMM is going to be playing the Dazzle. On the side of Revival Gaming, we have the Effety playing the Gyrocopter. Roger is going to be playing the Jakiro. He's still looking for a team, as you can see in his name. Revival G, Captain Love, is going to be on the Tusk. Leaving Velik to be playing the Invoker. And this is going to be the off-lane phases for it. Cyril, I think his name. I think H is pronounced as an R or something in Russian. I'm not 100% sure. Maybe someone in the chat can give me an answer. And yeah. With all of that said, we're going to get into the game. Aggressive movement coming out from PR. Looking for an easy kill here on top, but are they gonna find someone? The Effety is already standing away and he sees the boar coming in. They put down a ward. They're gonna try and fake it that it's a little bit further back. So this one doesn't get taken out. Same time. What's the Voiceless 4 doing? He puts down a ward here. This doesn't pluck the camp. I think it goes like this, so it should be okay. Does mean that it will most likely not be dewarded unless they put one down here. Pick that one still in the range, maybe here as well. But that one doesn't block anything in there. Doesn't matter too much. I need to get the new spawn boxes up again. That'll be cool. The battle begins. With that, if Lizard is in the stream here, if you want to come and co-cast the next one, it would be great. Because then I don't have to do it solo anymore. Stats is fun. But he won't respond to me. I'm so alone. That's it. Let's see if Aces Forge is gonna be solo up for now against Recovery. I think the Dazzle will come and rotate in, yeah. He's not gonna leave him alone there for too long. Let's see. How will this dual lane fare against the dual lane coming out from PR? Shouldn't be too easy for Revival. This is a pretty harass heavy lane. With the Beastmaster Double Boar already coming out, and of course the Undying. Okay, they're gonna turn it into a tri-lane, but even then, I think we are okay for now with it. They don't have to completely win the lane, but they just have to stop the Gyrocopter from complete and total free farm. And then here on their own lane, Phases Ford will just have his own problems dealing with the Dazzle and Sven combination. A lot of armor on this side as well. Weave plus Warcry, man, that's really hard to get through. With your physical damage. That said, Revival do have a lot of magic damage, so it's not the worst thing there is. As what? They get a kill on face? What the hell was he doing there? He still Stunwalk as well. I guess he got stunned up and then killed. I wasn't expecting him to give a first blood away. I was expecting to have something more happen here on the top lane. Where we have five heroes located. So we're probably a little bit too greedy. Don't really have a silence for him this game. They'll just have to rely on pure lockdown. Which is only really coming out from the Beastmaster once he's level 6. And from the Stormhammer for Sven. See the apathy, got on love. Book coming out here, so with that PR able to at least get the creep wave back to the tower and get some more experience and last hits coming away at the same time. This is just means that they're gonna get some jungle creeps here. Let's see. Well, with that it seems that PR might have put himself in a bit of a hole with the Gyrocopter on the other side. This set is absolutely not in favor of them. Oh yeah, yeah. Let's see. What would they do against the Faceless here? They kinda wanna get another kill on him, but he's now playing a lot safer. Yeah, meaning that Dazzle has to go for this art camp pool, but there you go, Faceless is saying, yeah, I'm not gonna make it that easy for you. With that they should be able to get it pretty far back. He's even gonna lose a range creep here, which is pretty nice. We'll start pushing out soon again. Don't think Sven is gonna pull them back now. Recovery is just letting it go. Just gonna farm it up on Nivus Tower. Gonna take it easy. Let's just take a quick look at mid. It's freaking dead even here. Zeus and Invoker both have 19 CS right now. There's a couple of denies on Valak though, so he should be a bit ahead. 80. Yeah, he's about 60 experience ahead. Oh, big. Oh, the shards push him the other way. He is. This is not going to be a kill here for Revival. Though, there is 19 CS at the moment on Gyrocopter. He's still farming pretty well. Really, Faceless is getting more out of his offlane here than the other one is. Random happy tree planted there. And Xenra is just running completely into them. He has a time warp, but can't get it off. With that, PR pick up the second kill of the match. And it's again on the Faceless. Walking a little bit aggressive, why didn't he just... I guess he wanted to go for the rune. Yeah, it was 4 minutes. So. This does give more space to the Dazzle as well as the Sven here to get the creep Echolurium back without giving Faceless Force too much experience. He will come back now. We'll get a card, but that's really going to be the end of it. Can't really do anything against this Leno anymore. The longer they wait, the more levels they're gonna get on the side of PR as well. It's kind of what they want. Once they get enough levels on Bigman and J4, they can also just rotate out. They're walking fairly aggressively forward. There's not a totem just yet, so he just has to do it with Soul Rip in DKs. Bigman is taking a lot of damage. Turn goes Rev come out, and they're at least able to first turn and run around on the gyrocopter. J4 is not really done yet. He has a stick. He's just gonna wait for his DK to also come off cooldown. There you go. He pops it now. He can put on the DK. Oh. They're all getting low. J4. Oh, he's able to dodge the charge for now, but what can he do? He buys the TP. He's trying to juke and jive. Sunstrike is gonna be off the mark. J4, he's gonna hide up here. And he just has enough mana. He's gonna TP out. He's gonna survive. And it's just gonna turn out to be a 1-for-1 trade. And in the end, it's gonna be pretty much even. But it's always good to stop their position 1 from farming. So in the end, it's kind of in favor of BR. The only problem is that... Okay, never mind. Bignum is actually already back to pick up this juicy experience. And Zeus got the bounty rune as well. It's a nice force spirit pickup there. Both runes going the way again of PR here. With the haste rune here on the Dazzle. Akon. Okay, thank you. Oh my god, Lizard studying scrub. But again, here on mid, it's still pretty even. With Valak getting a little bit more CS right now, since Zeus is focusing a bit more on getting runes as well. This sentry has been spotted, of course, by the sentry here from PR, so. Or sentry the observer, so. JJK will probably either take that out and they're gonna abuse the fact that they know that it is there and go for a smoke gank. Let's see. Heck on. Interesting name. Wondering if it's Hakon or Heckon. They say Heck on or Hakon. That's not them. Doesn't matter too much. Face is just blowing up here. They use the Tunico's Ref as well. No backtrack now anymore to take it away to get for the lucky escapes. Gyrocopters. Buying up a lot of stats here. Oh, that's gonna go for an Aquila here as well. Just gonna get those early stats going so you're able to fight it at pretty much this timing. Oh, TPs are coming in here. They wanna go for recovery, but he has been able to take the tower for now. Who's out the Stormhammer on Saren? Oh, Snowball comes forward and they're locking in recovery, but he is still pretty damn tanky here. Sunstrike is gonna be on the mark, but the split between two, and now he's gonna start TPing out Grave. Gets put on him as well. Well played there. Now he needs to get out on his own. And he's able to do so as the Snowball is still on cooldown for another 4 seconds. And there we go. Bignum picks up a casual kill here on top together with Cheshire Cat. Has the DD as well. And it's a little bit early, but let's just take a quick look at net worth. Still pretty damn even between Valak and Zeus. Cheshire Cat, he's taking a lot of damage from this one. There's a Chrono. They might want to go for RMM in here. Let's see what will they do. Ah, nice Chrono hitting two here. Do they have the damage? Sunstrike is going to be full up. Yes, that's going to be enough for now. At least they're going to get Captain Love. He will also be sent towards his grave there with the Stormhammer from Sven. Let's see. I'm not gonna say J4 is James, I'm just calling him J4. If you want to be called James, he has to ride it like James. See, Bignum, he has Roar. They really want to set up something here. They need to get a kill on Valak, that would be pretty damn big. Try to get Valak or get the Gyrocopter again. Ooh. Eating some lightning there. RMN. It's going for a little bit of a ward mission. There you go, they're even gonna smoke up as well. And they have already a double stack here. They know there's a ward here, so they're kind of abusing the fact that it's there. and go for a gank involving there. Hawk is gonna come out. They see the apathy. Apathy. Think we'll back off a little bit there. Put down a ward. They see him still. Is he gonna go for push? This is a stack. This is a stack. Are they gonna walk up here? They're waiting for Cheshire Cat to get close again. Oh, the tense is building up. What are they gonna go for? It seems that they will just go for the easy boring target. They're gonna go for Roger here. Galdos get put out. Oh! With the FT walking forward, you kinda wanna still wanna go for him, but they're a little bit too split up. Captain Love comes in to disrupt the fight, and Roger is able to just kill off J4 here, and he's just standing strong in the macropies, trying to get the totem away. Will be doing so successfully. As you know, we'll just be focused on by Bignum and RMM. On the same time, you could see up here, they were still able to get the kill on the gyrocopter. Deputy also sent to his grave. Tusk somehow was just lived through it all and survived and is now able to go back. Invoker even rotated in as well. The whole side of PR actually rotated, giving some space to Hakon here on bot. Hakon. I don't know if he's a boost or what is that really to have to do with anything with this. Let's see, okay. They're all resumed again. Velik. He has 2k gold. Is he gonna go for BOTs here, or is he opting to go for Link Dagger? That's the one. Link Dagger. You see when you get. That's really just the option right now. If you don't save up this much money if you're actually gonna go for something else than that. Alright, I'm able to escape here again. They're not gonna get a lucky bash coming out from Hakon. Okay, go back to Velik. It's gonna be the Blink Dagger. There you go. Just gonna say he doesn't collect that much money if he wants to go for Yules or anything. J4 is ready here on bot. It's going for the 2-2-2 build again. His favorite. Let's see. Gonna be the urn for Captain Love. Hakon, they seem to be returning back to bottom here. They can kill off J4 pretty easily if all of them set their mind to it. Is he gonna go aggressive into Roger here? That would probably be a mistake. Curry is not gonna spot him out. That's still a little bit low range there. J4. Does he know that there are lines? Now they're TPing back on the Tusk. And now they come in with Hakon! And Macropire gets put down as well. J4 is getting low. J4 is going to go down here. Well, here in the dire jungle. Bignum has been able to pick up the FT again. Just putting him back in the grave. This hurts him so much. He's just 4k in. Oh my god. Over 4k lead right now on PR. They're really just getting it going here. Their loss every single time is just J4. And that's not too bad. Time lapse out. I don't think they can really follow him up. They even stopped the TP as well. So they just focusing their attention here on top. Does mean that Cheshire Cat on bot has to take a little bit more space back in case there's a gank, like he knows there is. There you go, he's already back. Tier 1 will be taken after the glyph is over, as decided Revival Gaming are not making any movements towards it to defend. Oh, Toby 1. Ah, that hurts me, but it's okay. I hope you guys are still enjoying it. J4 might lose his life here again. He's half of the deaths of his team. Where's the other ones? Okay, one on Bignum and one on RMN. Ugh. You can't really pronounce it like that. That can be his name. It should be like an acronym for something, right? An abbreviation, or what is it? And they're just gonna set for the tier 1 push here. Trying to wrap around, get the weave out. Forge Spears will scout them out. They see the Asian stack. Or they're just gonna steal this one with the God Strength on. And yeah, Revival Gaming, they're not in any kind of position to really stop this. So they just have to let it go. But Ghost Franklin might just go for the tower here as well. Yeah, there you go. Still has it for another 10 seconds. They put down the glyph. That might just buy enough time for them to return. Ghost Frank is gonna wear off pretty much now. There you go. Back to his usual blue. But still, they're not in position to defend. Faceless on bottom. On the top, they have the Gyrocopter and the Jakiro. Seems like they're just okay with trading. Tower is gonna be glyphed up here as well for the side of PR. They're TPing in. Just one for now. It's just Cheshire Cat. Tower is gonna take down. Deny, deny, deny. No, Cheshire Cat is too late. The slow from Liquid Fire was too much. Tier 1 push here, mid commences. J4 pushes down the totem, trying to slow the apathy down. But there is absolutely no follow-up right now. Zeus was still too far away, and does Dazzle even have a point in Poison Touch? He does not. Oh, this is a nice stack here. Recovery, getting a lot of money from this. And this will give them a little bit more lead. No Tier 1 to be taken here. So just all grouping up there. That's a drawing from Big Num. Do they have a smoke? They have one on RMN. Okay, it's Roman. I'll just call him Roman then. That's easier for me. War Spirits. They're just gonna be farmed up. It will just go for the ward first, though, as Felix actually gets Stormhammered up. He goes Invis, but there comes the vision that they need in the form of the Zeus. And Recovery will pick up the kill. Well, 166 CS at the moment on this Sven, that's a whole lot. Ekon will be able to get out. See, Watcher getting the harassments going here on the tower again. J4 has to watch out. Ooh, even gets ice patted, but it's just to cover up the liquid fire spam again on the tower. Smoke is up here. There's gonna be TP in. This is the effigy. They might want to jump him. I think they will. Big Num has a roar. They put Warcry. They're gonna start rushing in. Blink comes out from recovery. The effigy is getting low. Effigy is able to get off the cooldown for now. Is it gonna be enough? No, as the roar will now finally come out. Recovery is underneath the tower. Nice charge, but oh, the shadow wave was a little bit too strong there. Can he kill off Big Num here in time before the graves comes out, before it all ends? No, the grave, it was mid animation in the end, but won't work out. Velik goes into Ghost Walk. Recovery is still looking for more as the blink forward comes into Hecon here. Small time walk away. Recovery will now have to start running away. Movement speed will be pretty high with Warcry on. Both sides of Blink, so they just opt to not go after him anymore. But they lost some more. Jakiro here on top. He also got ganked by the Zeus, plus most likely J4 as well, who was still there. And let's just take a quick look at how the graphs are going right now. Net worth pretty hefty in favor of PR for now. It's not the biggest of leads, it's about 500 gold more per minute, so still pretty nice for the 20 minute mark, or almost 20 minutes. Experience is a bit more. Really, Cheshire Cat has a Bloodstone now as well next to his Eaterlands, that's nice. Really, that increased cast range and damage is so incredible on the Zeus. Roger, can they do anything about this? Oh, that one was a bit too short. The tornado coming out from the Evoker over there. They're chasing after J4. He's just running away. This is just buying time for the tier 2 push here. They said with your gear down, I'm not even sure if Revival really want to fight. They kind of need the Macro Pyre plus Faceless Chronosphere combination if if they really want to get kills. At least it would help them out a lot. TPing here. Are they gonna smoke up? They have a smoke on Captain Love. Shakira's in front. Are they trying to bait with him? This is really obvious. They even walk forward now, yeah. I think if BR goes for the tier 2 push here, they will smoke up and go behind it. There you go. They're smoking up. They're gonna make their movement towards the tier 2 and stop them from doing it. And the Zeus ultimate comes out. Tunnicus Rev will spot them out. And they will just quickly split up and divide around the map and force them to essentially have a wasted smoke, apart from the fact they just go into Roshan here. And BR, they just all TP'd away. Did you see the ice? They have, okay, they have the Hawk here. But they can't really stop it anymore. Team No Cheshire Cat is walking towards it, but he's on his own. His team is a little bit too far behind us. They will still take an hour and 10 seconds. And how is Roshan doing at the same time? Roshan doesn't have another 10 seconds. Roshan is down. Gyrocopter has it. An instant, another instant smoke coming out, but this is, I think, spotted again. Yeah, they find Roger here. He's taking a lot of damage. And the Hawks, the recovery just blinks in to kill him off. They get the Aegis, but they lose to Jakiro, still more than worth it for the side of Revival Gaming. And they just take a tier 2 here on bottom. Most likely start looking for... I don't think PR really do... The recovery is walking up there. Not everybody is close. Roman still has some ways to go. I'm gonna kill the rocket. Just takes 3 hits. There you go. Everty almost lost his Aegis just to some small nuke damage here. They haven't even committed. They put down the tombstone. Now they're gonna commit for the tower. Putting in the damage here. But with the Calder and Glyph pop, they're gonna take a step back. There's a ward here, but I think the both sides know. And recovery goes in here on Roger. He's gonna blow him up. No, in time, the phase is four. The ultimate's gonna keep him there. But it's not enough. As they are able to kill him off with Tunnicus Rev, and they can't kill off recovery in time. He stays back. He even gets graved up just to be safe. Now Velik gets ward up. They need to put the damage in. Is he able to get out of here? He's trying to turn this one around. But is he able to do so? Big gun take a lot of damage. There you go. The tower hit will be enough to kill him off now. Echo needs to get away. FT is fighting up against them, but he has the Aegis. He doesn't care too much. Weave gets put out. They took a tier 3. The range wreck is almost down. Oh, tornado coming in. Connecting on just Cheshire. And he's in the ice wall. Oh, he is so slow, but he can always deny himself here. With the Bloodstone, he might have to do so as the rocket is going to hit him. There's going to be the grave. He needs to deny himself, and there you go. He will do so. You don't want to give him up. Don't want to give up that killing spree over there. All with all, it's still actually in favor of PR after the buyback on the Invoker. They did lose Zeus. But in the end, it doesn't matter too much. They even get the tower as well. With this, it's going to be a 10k lead for PR. As well as having the Rex exposed here on the bottom lane.
Time for a tag team.
I'll just ask what his name is after this game if they're true in the lobby. Jessica, I feel like going back. Okay, yes, the Aghanims actually, so he just wants to have this lower casting time. I think it also gives him an extra orb, right? Yeah, an S1 level. To the stats provided by Quadpex. Okay. Just gives a plus one level on everything as well. I forgot. I thought it just gives you one extra skill point to put in one thing, but it just gives a level on everything. Pretty nice item there. Low value out of it. Doesn't really have a lot to set it up with, but that's essentially what they have the Faceless as well as the Tusk for. They're gonna come in. Oh, Recovery, he is mad. He goes in aggressive. Everything gets low. Recovery with God Strength and BKB on is just too strong. Cheshire can take a lot of damage here, though, but he has been able to stay alive as the Grave comes out, as well as a lot of heals from the side. And there are four down on Revival already. This is gonna get turned into a fifth one as the Rampage completed for Recovery. And with this, it will most likely just be the end for revival. Recovery is it's just too big right now. They don't have the damage to kill them off. They got a pretty good chrono keeping everybody out, but it was already recovery going crazy on the apathy and killing him off. And there you go, Captain Love, he calls it. As we end it with a rampage for recovery on the Chen, and Chen on the Sven. They will go to the round of 8. I believe that's actually the quarterfinal then. Yeah, that's the quarterfinal. That will be another best of one. Let's take a quick look at the face it bracket. They're gonna be playing up a team called Rory. I absolutely don't know who they are. But yeah, this was Power Rangers against Revival Gaming PR1. I'm the caster at Thunder underscore Dota. On the stats, we have at Borno underscore as well, or dash one of those, so you will find him anyway. And we'll go into the break screen right now, and we'll hope to see you all back again for the next game between PR and Rory.